Hello. For this video, I thought I would make a Zen garden. I have seen these for a while now, and I thought I would finally make a video creating one. Let's begin. So, in the box, you get a set of different tools to use with the sand, and you can create different patterns with these. And that's one of them. Here's another one. This looks to be more like a classic kind of rake that you would use to rake up some leaves in the autumn time. I have no idea what this one is for, but it's an interesting shape. That one has four little prongs in the center. Kind of reminds me of the game of cricket. And this is the fifth one. This is slightly more imperfect. Those are the rakes that we have to use. In here, there looks to be some kind of mossy shrub and little flower. Very, very delicate. And these are very furry, very furry to touch. like a little green hedgehog. Very fuzzy. I imagine some people might not like the texture. If you don't like the feel of velvet, you might not like this. This is a bigger one. This is exactly the same texture. They're very light as well. I believe they might have polystyrene inside, and then glue, and then you can get a shaker which has the grass in, and it comes out in shards. I think that's maybe how this was created. If you like making dioramas and things, then you'd be familiar with that method. Lastly, in this bag, is a very cute little bridge. It's even got the detailing of the little bricks. It's in the kind of oriental style too. Next we have two, I believe they would be blossom trees. Slightly lopsided. Let's see if we can fix it. These are wire, so you can actually bend them into your desired shape. Some excess glue. Very pretty. I happen to love blossom trees. It's one of my favourite trees. I also like willow trees as well. This one is freestyling, so I think we'll leave it to be as it is. I quite like things when they're not perfect, makes them more interesting. So, next up. A beautiful tower, another little ornament to add to our garden. These are very well made actually. The painting on them is very clean, and there's even little steps just there. The roof is actually tiled as well. Kind of reminds me of dragon scales. I think the buildings in Japan and places similar like this are very beautiful. And a lot of them are sacred as well. The architecture is really unique to anything we have anywhere else in the world. Next we have three stones, a larger stone, a medium-sized stone, and a little baby stone to go on top. These remind me of the stones that are heated up and placed on people's backs in spas. I've never actually been to a spa myself, but I've seen it in movies. Came in this bubble wrap, teeny tiny bubble wrap. See if we can pop them. Oh, they're so cute. To leave that, or I will just end up playing with that the whole time. We also have a bag of stones to create perhaps a path or something. Now we have the bag of sand, which I believe is inside another bag, which was a good idea because I'm quite chaotic with this sort of thing. Okay. Now we have the base itself. It's quite messy in the box. Okay. More bubble wrap for later. Base. Okay, I've moved you a bit closer so you can actually see as I'm making the garden. So first we will start with the sand. Has already exploded into the bag. Okay. I'm now going to use this to push the sand around to make an even surface. Don't think I'm doing a very good job. Make sure we cover all of the corners. I'm sure we have some Zen Garden experts out there somewhere that could maybe give some advice for next time. Okay, I cheated, but now we have a perfectly even spread, so. Right, I think we will start by using these rocks that we have. I think we'll make a little path moving from one edge of the garden to the other. So I will just roughly outline. Looks like a cat's paw prints. It would be adorable if I could get my dog to stand in this. He has little paw beans, and that would look rather cute. Maybe we have a circle here. Wider, maybe. You can add whatever you want to this. Some people out there may have a miniature dollhouse. You could certainly add things from there if you wanted. Some really tiny, tiny, tiny ones in here. Really tiny. It almost gets lost under my claws. There's no wrong way to do this either. It's pretty much just have fun and make whatever you want. Now I can fill this one in a bit more. It's looking a bit bare. And use the little ones to fill it in. This one looks a little bit like a dragon egg. Maybe there are dragons in this garden. Okay. Might make a little corner here using some of the darker stones just for some contrast. Now I have some spare, so I will decide what to do with those. later. Let's make some patterns. I'm just going to use this rake. Going to use this smaller one to carve out the path that we've just put down. So in this circle here, I'm going to put this tower. And it is surrounded by the wall of stones that we put down. Might even strengthen its defenses by placing some more. Just there. So now if any enemies try to attack, it will be harder to break down the walls. Tiny, tiny, tiny stones. Rather ticklish. Okay. See what shape this makes. I think now we will place these rocks somewhere. Perhaps in this corner here. And they are flat on the bottom, so makes it easier to stack them. Now we have these. Little green hedgehogs. And I'm just going to place them perhaps here. Now we have this bridge. And I'm going to place it along the path. I'm just going to squish these aside to make room just there. Just there. Perfect. And now I'm going to use this rather peculiar looking tool to make some different patterns. Seem to have buried the stones, so we'll pick them out. I think here we will have one of our trees. Perhaps this one fits perfectly in that little space. There we go. This area is a sacred area, and so we have protected it with another stone wall just here. And now we have the little lotus style flower. I think we should place this perhaps here. This area is water. which is why these mossy stones have emerged. And here are where the lilies are. So now we have one more tree. And I figure this may too go. Near the garden, perhaps. Or here. Near our sacred stone tower. Now, we do have some little stones left, and I would hate to waste anything, so we should maybe pop these here too, to guard this tree. Whenever you drop something, you have to re-rake it because otherwise the pattern is spoiled. There we go. I do have one more little surprise to add to my garden. Ta-da! This is the protector of our garden. Where should we place him? Here, perhaps. Where the water is. Right at the front. I have many more Pokemon. Perhaps I will make another one so that they too can have a home. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope you have enjoyed this video. Take care.